Hi everyone, welcome to Think Smart Home. If you have seen my previous videos, you might have noticed that I have used Synology DSM extensively in my tutorials. Synology DSM is a powerful NAS operating system with tons of features and applications. If you want to know more about DSM, I'll leave the link to their website down in the description below. Ideally, to run DSM, you must have a Synology hardware, which I do understand might be a bit pricey for some user, even though I think it's really worth the money. So I highly recommend you to buy a real Synology NAS if you can. But if you cannot buy it, then it's not end of the world. And at today's video, I'll show you how you can install Synology DSM on your PC. We will be using a loader utility called ARC Loader, which will fake your hardware into RS4021XS Plus, which is the registration from Synology. So what do we need? We need to download the ARC Loader, and then we need to download this utility called Rufus, and then we need a USB drive. So we will use the Rufus utility to burn the loader into the USB drive and create a USB bootable drive which will fake our hardware into RS4021XS Plus. I'll leave the download links to both Rufus utility and the loader down in the description below. So the first step is to download the loader. Since I'm going to install DSM on a bare metal, so that's why I will be downloading the image file. There are other options as well if you want to run the DSM as a virtual machine. So just click on this file to download it. I've already downloaded this file, so I'll use that file to burn using Rufus utility. To burn the image file, just run the utility as an admin. Plug in your USB drive, it will automatically pick up your USB drive and then give it a path to your loader which you just downloaded, and then leave everything as default and then click start. It will give you a warning, click OK. This might take a while to burn the loader into the USB drive. While it is happening, please take some time to give this video a thumbs up. Also, consider subscribing to this channel and press the bell icon to get notified when I release any video about smart home automations or home network security and storage. Alright, so now the format is complete. So we will plug this USB into our PC and boot it using this USB drive. Alright, so here we are in my server cabinet. I have plugged in the USB drive to my old Z800 workstation, which is the HP machine basically. So now we will be booting this machine using the USB drive. We don't need to do anything in here, so just plug in the USB drive and reboot the machine, and the loader should do all these things. Please be advised that Ethernet or the network connection should be a wired one because the wireless connection is not supported at the moment. If everything goes well here, loader will boot up the DSM and IP address will be assigned to our newly created NAS. So we can just use that IP address to access and set up the NAS. Alright, so IP address has been assigned to our NAS. So we can simply use this IP address to access and set up our NAS from any PC. Alright, so we are back on our PC now. So we just have to call the IP address followed by the port number which was showed on the PC when loader just loaded up. So in my case, since I already set it up, so that's why it is detecting the already installed DSM. In your case, it should be a fresh install. So you can simply click on install and then it will ask you to either browse to your DSM file or you can automatically download the DSM file for your rack station. In our case, it is RS4021 XS Plus. So I'll simply select the first option and then click on next. So this might take some time because it will be downloading the disk session manager and then installing it on your PC. So now the DSM installation is complete, so it's just rebooting the PC. So after the reboot is complete, we should be able to log in to our DSM, or we should be able to create a new admin account and then log in to our DSM. Please be advised, since this DSM is not installed on official Synology hardware, so you will not have any support from Synology if something goes wrong. It's not recommended to use this for your production applications or services. You might use this for your test or lab setups, and I highly recommend to buy a real Synology hardware if you plan to host your critical data on it. Alright, so looks like it's ready to go, so I click on start and then give your NASA name. And then create an admin name with the password. You can check this one, it will display this one into your Synology web assistant to help you find the NAS in case it reboots or it cannot be detected under this IP address. Now on this page, to select an option for update, since this loader is purely for 7.2, so in next update this loader might stop working. So if you really want to keep this one online or working, I suggest to select the third option, which will not install any update automatically, and you can pick and install the updates which you want. That will at least not break your loader and this DSM will keep working. Click next. And since this is not officially supported by Synology, so you will not be able to use these services which are coming from Synology. So you can skip these ones. You can skip this one as well and then click on submit. All right, so our DSM is installed and it's ready to go. So you can set it up the way you want. And now you can verify your hard drives to make sure all your hard drives which are in your PC, they are already in there. So I have four hard drives in my PC which are being displayed over there. You can also verify your hardware by going to the control panel and then click on Info Center. You can use the package manager to install the packages from Synology. Alright, so that's it for this video. I hope you liked it. Please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel. I'll see you in the next video.